The Great Roman Empire has several reasons why the Roman Kingdom or the Roman Empire is considered so extraordinary. The Roman Empire is one of the largest empires in human history. At its peak, its territories covered most of Europe, a significant portion of the Mediterranean Sea, a considerable part of North Africa, and some areas in West Asia. The empire spanned approximately 4.4 million square kilometers, making it twice as large as the US. Remarkably, it all began from a small village in Italy. Looking from a modern perspective, the Roman Empire included regions like Albania, Austria, Algeria, Belgium, Bosnia, Bulgaria, Croatia, Egypt, England, Greece, Hungary, Iran, Israel, Italy, Jordan, Lebanon, Libya, Morocco, Portugal, Slovenia, Spain, Switzerland, Syria, Turkey, and Ukraine. Roman culture made substantial contributions to art, architecture, literature, and philosophy. Their monumental works, such as the Colosseum and enduring structures like the Alcantara Bridge in Spain, built by the Empire's Emperor in 106 AD, showcase their engineering prowess. Major literary works like Virgil's epic poems and the philosophical writings of Seneca, originated from Rome. Even the Roman emperors themselves, such as Caesar, contributed to the Empire's cultural heritage. Their legacy includes constructing a bridge nearly 2,000 years ago, still standing and in use today, the Alcantara Bridge in Spain. The inscription on the bridge mentions, "I have built a bridge that will last forever." The concrete or cement they used in ancient times is still in use in contemporary constructions. The military might during the Republic and early Roman Empire is regarded as one of the greatest in world history. Disciplines, training, military organization, tactics, formations, and even doctrines like divide and conquer, used by modern militaries, were adopted from the Roman military. The Roman legal system formed the basis for almost all modern legal systems worldwide. Concepts such as innocent until proven guilty and individual rights in court originated from Roman law. Many Latin terms are widely used in everyday life, and even most scientific terms have Latin roots. The Roman alphabet itself traces its origins back to Latin. Latin, a once daily used language in the Western Roman Empire, influenced more than just language. The Romans didn't only have one month, but even 2 months named directly after Roman emperors: July, named after Julius Caesar, and August, named after Emperor Augustus. Even great figures in the centuries after the fall of Rome were obsessed with it. Charlemagne conquered much of Europe 300 years after the fall of Rome, and named it the Holy Roman Empire. Sultan Mehmed II of the Ottoman Empire conquered Constantinople, calling himself the Roman Emperor, though he didn't rule Rome. German kings named themselves Kaisers, and Russian kings called themselves Tsars, both originating from the Roman title of Caesar. Having acquired power as a dictator, implemented several political reforms and boasted military victories. Nevertheless, Caesar's assassination triggered chaos in the Republic. Mark Antony and Octavian formed an alliance known as the Second Triumvirate to confront conspirators and engage in further civil battles. Octavian, also known as Augustus, laid the groundwork for the Roman Empire and became its first emperor, marking the end of the Roman Republic. While the empire reached its zenith in the 2nd century CE, various crises such as barbarian invasions, political instability, and economic factors led to its decline. In 476 CE, the Western Roman Empire collapsed due to barbarian invasions, giving rise to a new kingdom of Italy. Meanwhile, the Eastern Roman Empire, or Byzantium, endured into the medieval era. Constantine the Great moved the capital to Byzantium, and Byzantium persisted with greater wealth and stability than the Western Roman Empire. Known as the Byzantine Empire, it survived until 1453 when Constantinople was captured by the Ottoman Empire. Despite the fall of the Roman Empire, its cultural legacy and contributions to art, architecture, and law continue to influence the world today.